In this video, I will present 5 simple tips for selecting the right colors for your designs. So you will never have to pull your hair while trying to figure out the color palettes for your projects. One of the most important elements of interfaces today is definitely the color. It sets the tone, feelings and emotions associated with using the app or other digital products we are designing. Choosing the right colors is also one of the most problematic areas for many of us designers. Let me start from something that may turn your approach upside down. Because in contrast to what a lot of us designers do, you actually should never start designing with color. It's better to start designing in grayscale first. Because of that, you will be able to focus more on creating a solid visual hierarchy rather than exploring possible color combinations. Focus first on objects that are most important for your users in the context of actions available on the screen. Think in terms of visual weight. Use size, negative space, and position to distinguish what is most important, and only then follow up with applying color to the interface. Next step in figuring out the color scheme for your project is to use branding as a guideline. Using a brand color as a baseline is no brainer really. Depending on the case, you may use one or more of the brand colors to apply to the palette of your project. Brand should play a key role in creating a color scheme. But what about the situation where you are still in the process of defining it? Here with the help comes color psychology. Color psychology is the study of how colors affect perceptions and behaviors. It's focused on how colors impact consumers' impressions of a brand and whether or not they persuade consumers to consider specific brands or make a purchase. Think about the industry that your product is intended for and then see what color corresponds with its brand promise. Pick a variation of that color. Now, you have your primary brand color. You can supplement it through complementary colors, following one of the color wheel schemes. There are many variations to this, so I will leave that to your own experiments. But from my experience, simplicity is a key. Now you have your color options, but how to find a good balance between them and apply to your interfaces? Here with the help comes 60-30-10 rule. 60-30-10 is very simple. When you create a new color palette, the 60% of that palette should be dedicated to one color, which is usually a neutral one. Then complementary color makes up 30% of that palette. And a third accent color is used for the remaining 10% of the design. Most of the time, it will be primary brand color or a variation of it. You can see how it works in the presented example. The design on the left was created without that rule. The design on the right was redesigned by me according to 60-30-10 rule. Most well-established products and designers use this rule to achieve harmony in their designs, along with a shape. Color is something that users rely on when interacting with our designs. It should serve a clear functional purpose. You should use color as a functional element to simplify the process of interaction with your product. Use color to focus users' attention, describe the current state of an object, or to distinguish interactive from static objects. You also need to make sure that color is used consistently throughout all of your screens. If you decide to use a specific color for an object, this color should be used in all parts of your project. It will give users the ability to rely on their previous interactions with various parts of your product. No matter what colors you choose to use in your design, it's essential to test your color combinations both with accessible testing tools and real users. The right contrast between text and background is essential for good user experience. Each time when you place two colors with low value contrast next to each other, you make your copy very difficult to read. WCAG2 requires a contrast ratio of at least 4.5 to 1 for normal text and 3 to 1 for larger one, as well as interface components. Use tools like WebAIM to check if your color palette passes all tests. Nowadays, many brands and designers use bright colors for their designs. Bright colors give energy and modern feeling, but on many occasions those colors are failing accessibility standards. So be careful and double check everything before you proceed to apply your color palette to your project. I hope that after watching this video you won't struggle with colors anymore. If you want to learn something else today, you can watch this video here. You can also support my channel by subscribing and liking this video, which will help spread my knowledge further.